tall versus short and the back squat. Who's gonna be better at it? A taller person or a shorter person? Let's figure it out. From a topical viewpoint, lifting will always be different based on how you're built, and that's just how it is. That's why some people are built for some lifts while others are built for other lifts. When it comes to the back squat specifically, taller folks generally have a tougher time doing this movement. Well, why is that? Well, for starters, number one is they have a longer way to travel, so their range of motion is greater than a shorter person. So that means that they're gonna have to displace their body over a greater range of motion and put out more work to complete successful reps. The second reason is with longer limbs and longer leverages, your mobility is gonna be needing to be upped a little bit. So for example, a longer individual who has longer legs is gonna need a little bit more ankle mobility than the shorter individual who doesn't have to travel as far to sink to depth. The third reason is that the upright torso. So the upright torso in the taller person is generally a little bit harder to maintain, and that again relates to their height and their leverages and how the bar is placed on the back posteriorly. Now, when it comes to should tall people back squat, that's a better question. Let's dive into that. So let's look at two examples here. I'm on the left at about 6 foot. My buddy Jared Stein is on the right at about 5'9". Now, Jared is an extremely strong squatter, and there are guys that are much taller than myself, so keep that in mind as we discuss. So one main difference between taller and shorter lifters when it comes to the high bar back squat specifically is that with longer limbs, the knees are gonna have to track a little bit more, and again, the mobility is gonna have to be a little bit more in the ankle. As you can see, my ankle mobility could still be a little bit better, and that would help me keep my hips under me a tad more. Another difference that you'll probably notice with taller lifters is the bar path. It's a lot more difficult, I think, to maintain that midline position to a T for taller lifters. So what I like to do is I like to use balance as my guide. If I'm staying balanced and not falling forward, then that's generally a good bet that I'm maintaining a good bar position. If you are a little bit forward and you have balance, I wouldn't stress it too much. Just keep it in mind and be objective with your form. All right, this video is not intended to say the back squat is a must for everybody. I'm just saying that different lifts will always feel tougher and easier based on how you're built. Now, when it comes to the back squat, specifically for tall people, that is not a movement that plays into our favor. It's a movement that's gonna take a little bit more work. And that being said, I have three tips to help you out if you are a taller individual with your back squat. Number one is to work on your lower body mobility a little bit more before getting under the bar. Spend a little bit more time on the ankle and working through flexion of the ankle and trying to get comfortable hitting depth and letting those knees track a little bit more. My second tip is to elevate the heel. A lot of times people veer away from weightlifting shoes or elevating the heel because the knees shouldn't come over the toes. Well, guess what? If you're tall, the knees are gonna be coming over the toes. Otherwise, you're gonna be doing some weird ass hip squat and it's not gonna get you anywhere. So elevate the heel. Do not be afraid to elevate the heel to work on torso mechanics and so forth. My third tip is to actually do more anterior loading versus posterior loading. Front-loaded squats like the front squat, the Zercher squat, the goblet squat are all fantastic variations for working your torso angle mechanics and just getting comfortable hitting depth while fighting to maintain an upright torso. It can be a little bit harder with the posterior load to maintain that torso angle, so doing more front-loaded options is a good bet in improving this mechanics of the back squat. Tall folks, I hate to say it, but the back squat is probably never gonna feel super comfortable for you. But don't worry, we have the deadlift and other movements that our leverages play into our favor with. Now, when it comes to being taller and back squatting, I don't think taller individuals should steer away from it. I think we should try to work with the leverages and the mechanics that we have individually and then go from there. I think veering away from any movement because it doesn't work into our favor can lead us to some other problems down the road, and it kind of just limits our potential in learning and teaching ourselves about how we move with certain loads in uncomfortable positions. So if you're a taller individual, try some of these tips out, see if they help with the back squat, and if you have any other questions or if you've learned anything along the way, drop comments down below. Would love to answer and love to have some feedback on this topic. We'll be right back.